Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode here in the satisfactory update for experimental build. So it's very experimental, guys. So I don't have any bugs, just crashes when loading, but nothing too serious. So how you guys doing? Hope you're doing well. So previous episode we set up that stuff, we did like the hub upgrades, we got some nodes, I added the second smeltery because we need to do something, so we need to start getting some base building. So I've been a little bit of a busy bee here with the off camera stuff, and I have a few things ready to go, so that will take 2 minutes to leave. That's cool. We need to start getting some stuff done. So, because I don't want to mess up my resources with the ones that I have already supplied, yeah, let's take some things down and start getting things done. Pick up miner, like, don't need this power pole, this thing. So I have put some biomass since we unlock it, so it's called 60 seconds. Yeah, so we have stuff in here, so yeah, don't you worry about that. So yeah, we need a couple of things in here. So guys, don't forget to hit the subscribe and like button, the bell notification, follow me on Twitter. Like, I've been semi-active, not really, but I'm trying to do things. But yeah, I'm gonna have a fun series in here. So yeah, we have some nice biomass and we need to start getting. So I found out if you space once, like you hear on my space, like it automatic crafting. I didn't know that, but just learning it, it's awesome. Yay. So we need to start getting some like automation started. So I'm gonna put a nice power pole that we are gonna connect there. So we need a miner. The first thing first, we need one of the portable miners, 10 plates and 10 concrete. So concrete, it's big. So, and our pod have returned, so we need to go to the next thing to put to be able to build resource. This is a normal vein for limestone. So exchange concluded. Fix it, freighter re-entry complete. Yep. And so now we have foundations. We need concrete. So concrete, it's one of the things that you try to set up as early as possible, like pretty early. So yeah, let's make a little bit of stuff so you can see what automation we are gonna talk about, like in general. So we need some of those, we need a little bit of concrete, so one space, and it's auto craftable, pretty cool. And so let's put the next thing, which is gonna be logistics. So yeah, we need to be careful about what we are building, because I have made some stuff. Exactly. So we have a miner. As you can see, we can put it anywhere we want. I'm gonna put it right there. And yeah, let's put all the stuff that I grabbed back. We don't really want to use them, trust me. Have calculated them correctly into the point. So we need some road and some concrete. Let's go do that. Yeah, that's the basic automation. You start doing that and you start getting like resources. This is the first thing you need to do in order to start getting things done. So let's get a second pole because we want to use this. So this is started and we are making 40 power, 50 megawatts, and we're consuming 5. So the next thing first, next we need some smelter. So I'm gonna put that there. You see, like it had like a gripping line or some sort. So yeah, in order to, we need some conveyor belts and we need some iron plating. So as you see, like, iron plating is gonna be one of the main things that we're gonna need. So yeah, it's a main resource, like iron. Later on, I'm gonna have more variable stuff. So we do that there, so we have power. And if we connect that there, I saw a little bit of spike lag, but yeah. So the, so if I put a little bit of inside, if we will do that. So the, we have a look at tower, we can put that later, that's fine. In the conveyor belt, that can transfer 30 resource per minute. So we are making 30, so that's not bad. This is takes 30, it makes 30. Cool. I believe, yeah, I think we are gonna delete some of that. We don't really need it, but yeah. So next thing, oh, I didn't put the stuff. Whoa. And I'm like, why is that not working? No, really.
Milestone reached. Conveyor belts can now merge, split, and lift to increase the complexity and efficiency of your factory. We encourage you to consider more verticality.
So that's gonna take 4 minutes. So we need to build. So we got the conveyor belt lifting. We didn't have back then in the, like, update one, or I think at least update two, we needed them probably. Like, we didn't have those, and you have to kind of make a spiral to do vertical stuff. Yeah, old fun time. So we need a constructor. So if I find the spot a little bit there, why did you mess up my OCD? Like, come on. I trusted you and you failed me. And we don't have iron, so let's get some iron, more plating. So as you see, it's quite a bit of process. I'm gonna make this first building, and then I'm gonna do some stuff outside the rest, and yeah, show you what I mean. So that nice. The constructor, we're gonna set up four iron plates. So you can see, like, we have wire, we have cable, concrete, biomass, screws. So iron plates, we need, which makes, we need 30 to make 20 per minute. So we connect that there, and yep. So if we take that and help it a bit. And how much do we need for our storage? 10 rods. We have enough already. And let's grab these leaves, because we're gonna use biomass for sure, so it's not a big deal. But so there, so we're gonna use a little bit of plating, but it's okay, we are making more. So yeah, we have automated iron plates. So this is pretty much what we're gonna make for the whole series, like, not that specific, but this is the general idea. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take the second node, which is also an impure one, and start making some iron rods. And I believe we could make I'm not so sure about the screws, but yeah, iron rods, and probably get concrete making. Like, concrete making, it's one of the most important ones that is need to be going, so we can start getting some basic supplies. So see you in a little bit.
Milestone reached. Biofuel will ensure maximum efficiency of biomass burners. To aid in biofuel production, you are now capable of removing foliage that consists primarily of wood. Additionally, R&D inflated your pocket dimension. M- milestone reached, the molecular analysis machine, referred to as the MAM, will allow R&D to provide new technologies, items, and buildings based on samples collected in the field.
So, guys, I'm back. I unlocked a few things. The most important, I unlocked the chainsaw. So, 5 barrel reinforced planes, rods, plate stuff. Yeah, we have a chainsaw. And we have a second dimension pocket. I also researched the field so we can make the MAM. The MAM is an important thing. I'm gonna look it later. But the chainsaw, I made some solid biofuel. Nice. Hiya. Yeah. So this is like small things. The most important one are, wow, we have some nice weird terrain glitches. I don't know if that's a thing, but yeah, these trees, these big trees, with one cut we have cut them. That's what, it's a big deal, because biofuel, solid biofuel, we are gonna use it. It's gonna be a main thing, it's gonna be a manual thing, it's gonna be an automated thing, it's gonna be our rail game power for a bit and leave. So you see, we are getting way more, like way more stuff. It has a small range. I would like to make a mark too. The some point they need to make a mark too that has a way bigger area, but yeah. I had made a modded playthrough on my own. There was a mod that made a, like a Mark II, and had a huge area, like it was huge area. But yeah, I'm gonna hear this thing, this sound, we're gonna hear it quite a bit, and I'm gonna use it for a while. So yeah, and a solid biofuel, let me show you one bit. It's made from biomass and from wood. We are getting tons and tons of biomass, like it's quite a bit, and that's why you need like the chainsaw, so you can get wood quite a bit. And so yeah, 8 biomass though, it makes 4 biofuel. So you are sitting here, you are doing that, and it's produced quite a bit of power, actually quite a bit. Yeah, so yeah, I had to show you that. And we could also take a look, a real quick look at like we have plates, so it's gonna be enough to make some more reinforced plating. And sorry about the noises outside, sorry about that. So we need 5 and 15, so we definitely have the cable. We need to, I need to get also copper, like automated, so that's the next thing. So I'm gonna have enough screws and yep, we are having. So let's make this reinforced plating. Another, like in early game, reinforced plating, it's a pain to make. But yeah, later on it's way better. So the MAM is used to be inside your thing, but they removed so you can research everywhere. So yeah, the MAM. So organics, flower petals, we have 10 of those, so that's fast. Okay. So color gun needs plates, needs screws, needs things, so that's gonna be a minute. And this is the color, so this is the coloring. So we have some berries and we can search the berries, the bear nut, and that needs some more stuff to research. Yeah, you are researching things and you are getting more fun. The MAM is an important like thing, it's an important thing quite a bit. Like we are gonna need it, we need hard drives. We are gonna mess with hard drives pretty soon if we find one. So biomass from things. When I kill more, I will research some of the things. I might do it, you know, off camera and such. So yeah, I mean, in the process right now, I was just about to start getting some more constructor to get the iron rod stuff. So yeah. All right, guys, I'm back. So we have a bit of a situation in here. How gonna fit a few things? So because we don't have foundations yet, and yeah, as you can see, some stuff don't fit too well in here, but we're gonna make it work. We're gonna make it work. So we need rods. We're gonna need two of them. So that's why we made the logistics first, that we took the splitter. So the splitter, it splits stuff into amounts. So if I place that there, kind of like that, okay, that's possible. All right, that's okay. And that's that. It's gonna clip inside that. I don't care. All right, so we need a power pole. Then I'm gonna connect there and there. And I'm gonna stress a bit the power, so we are almost close to a point that we need definitely a second one. But what we need to do in one of them, let's say in this one, which is fairly closer, better, we don't have cable, and we need to get rid of this. Okie dokie. So as you see, we are close at what these two can do. I made a bit of solid biofuel, so we are burning at 10 to 2.5 a second, so this is how much it lasts. So like, we are using 4 every minute, so which is really good. That's the two biomass though that we have in the base. If we make external, which we are gonna make one, because we definitely gonna need it. And because making biomass by hand, it's not the ideal one, it's kind of bad. So yeah, so if we make a second constructor, we put it, actually, can we put it kind of down here like that? Oh, nope, we need, gonna put a storage between, because really, yeah, I don't have a depth perception because I don't have the snapping points. So I'm gonna put that thing there with a second constructor right there. I'm gonna put that there, nice. And we're gonna make screws, because it takes 10 rods and to make 40 screws. Yeah, so it's a little bit, it's a little bit weird. Yeah, so we are close to 34. Like, we definitely gonna need one. So I'm gonna put also a second thing in here. We need iron rods, which we are gonna take from this one, since we have them. And let's put a second storage as well in this thing. So we are storing iron rods. That's nice. We are gonna store a little bit more of excess iron rods from there, and we're gonna do that there. Nice. So we have the basic automation. Like, this is the bare mode, the bare minimum bare mode. What? The bare minimum of automating plates, iron rods, and screws. That is what will make us what we need. So in terms of power, the biomass burner, which I'm gonna put definitely one back here, because making biomass, like I said, it's gonna take a minute. So with a constructor, if I make a little bit more of reinforced we can make the reinforced. We need just two plates. Okay, so this process is going to be way easier now that we have the iron plates plus that stuff. So if we put that there, yeah, there are some graphical glitches. So biomass from leaves, because leaves we take more, so it's take 120 per minute, so we are not even close to that. We make 60, so yeah, it makes like it will make half of this amount, like it's gonna make 30 a minute. So in terms of biofuel that needs 120 biomass, it's gonna make a less more for the leaves at least. For the wood it's 60 to 300, so still not gonna make enough to produce. But yeah, we need about 4 constructors, and yeah, this one biomass fuel, it's gonna make my life just a tiny bit more easier when I set it up with some more biomass. So let me go do that. And as usual, I'm getting ahead of myself. So yeah, we need to make a constructor and we need to start getting some concrete made, because yeah, it's a thing. We need to get it. So snap that. I brought some more power cable, so that there. So we're using 45, we're making 60. It's okay, like not a big deal. But yeah, concrete, it's one of those things that we need to get it. So we're making 40, and I'm gonna crash my thingy because my power will run out if I don't do something about it, like pretty fast. Yep, I saw that one coming. That is called forgot to get some more biofuel inside. So I'm gonna put some biomass for now in this biomass burner. So it's not the best, but it's okay. It will last for long until I'm continue building the final thing for today. All right, I'm back. So yeah, the power pole spaghetti thing, it's a lot. So if I put some wood in here, theoretically it will go there, so that's good. And if I put some leaves in here, that will go there. So I added some buffers, so at least we have some stuff. So I'm gonna put a few biomass there and gonna have some biofuel come out of here into some nice storage. Pretty cool, I have to say. So we have that automated. Probably I will go around get just a tiny bit more, because we are gonna need it. We are already using one biomass burner, and we are already at 70 megawatts. We are using like 43.4. don't know why that much, but okay, I guess. So this is cruising along well. This is like almost filling. That's nice. That's a nice thing to see. This thing is 500, so it's gonna take a minute before it filled up, but we are gonna need it. So this is not backstopped yet. It's about to be backstopped with stuff, and this is going nice and slowly. So yeah, we are doing pretty good. So concrete, they changed the stack size of concrete. It's now at 500 instead of 100, which is epic. It's epic. So the lookout tower, I don't know where we can put that to get a nice view of what we did today. I don't think we can put it up top out here, but no, we cannot put it. We will find another place to be. Okay, up here I guess it's gonna be a good spot to put the lookout tower. Nice. Yeah, we don't have like the thing, but that's a pretty nice view actually of our factory. Yeah, let's make a photo. So yeah, we have pretty much what we need to continue. So I will leave this factory to run for a bit to do some stuff, like prepare what we need. We need to have copper be made as soon as possible. And yeah, we can start getting some base stuff planned, but I don't know how I'm gonna do it. I don't know. We will see. So guys, don't forget to hit the subscribe and like button, and I will see you in the next episode of Satisfactory Update 4. Have a wonderful day, guys. Bye.